Hello students, in this video we are going to see correlation coefficient and its interpretation. Consider an example, compute correlation coefficient, interpret its values for the following data. The data is given, the bivariate data in x and y terms. This is a given problem that compute correlation coefficient and interpret its values for the given data. So, to find out the correlation coefficient, we have to consider the formula. So, the correlation coefficient is denoted by letter R. Generally, it is denoted by letter R, which is the ratio between covariance between x and y to the product of standard deviation in x and standard deviation in y. So, to find out the correlation coefficient R, we require to find out covariance, then standard deviation in x and standard deviation in y. So, separately writing those formulas for covariance in x and y variable, we have to find sum of xy by n into the product of x mean and y mean. To find the standard deviation in x, standard deviation in x, which is denoted by sigma x, is equal to square root of sum of x square upon n minus mean of x values square, and the standard deviation in y, standard deviation in of y is equal to square root of sum of y square upon n minus y mean square, that is y mean square. And as we all know, x mean is equal to sum of x values upon n, and y mean is equal to sum of y upon n. So these are the formulas to consider while solving the given problem or to compute the correlation coefficient R. So by the given data x and y, we will first draw a table of x, y, x square, y square, and x into y. X and y are given 2, 10, 3 square. Here we will write down x square terms here. 2 square is 4, 3 square 9, 4 square 16, 25. 36, and in y square terms, we will write down y square terms, 10 square, 100, 169, 16 squares, 256, 19 square, 361, and 22 square, 484. Now x into y term, x into y, 2 tens are 20, 39, 64, 95, and 132. Now the total of x, y, x square and xy, the sum of x is 20, sum of y is 80, sum of x square is 90, sum of y square is 1370, sum of xy is 350. So using these values, we have to just put all these computed values in these formulas, so we'll get the intended result. So first of all, x mean is equal to sum of x by n, that means 20 by 5 will get x mean as 4. Now y mean is equal to sum of y means 80 by n means 5 will get 16. Now standard deviation of x in x is equal to square root of sum of x square means 90 upon 5 minus x mean square. X mean, that means 4 square. After computing this, we'll get 10 by 5, which means under root 2, and the value of under root 2 is equal to 1.41421 approximately. So the standard deviation x is 1.41421. Now to find out standard deviation in y is equal to square root of sum of y square is 1370 by n means 5 minus y mean is 16 square, will get under root of 18 is equal to 4.24264. So the standard deviation in x is equal to 1.41421 and standard deviation in y is equal to 4.24264. After that, we are going to find out the covariance between x and y variable. So for the covariance, the formula is sum of xy upon n minus product of x mean and y mean. Sum of xy is 350 and the product of x mean y mean is 64. So 350 divided by 5, that is covariance in x and y is equal to sum of xy is 350 divided by n, that means 5, minus product of x mean into y mean is equal to 64, because x mean is 4 and y mean is 16 fours are 64. So the answer to this is 6. So now correlation coefficient r is equal to covariance between x, y divided by standard deviation in x into standard deviation in y. So covariance in x and y is 6 that we have computed here, and standard deviation in x is equal to 1.41421 into standard deviation in y is equal to 4.24264. After computing this, we'll get the result 1, that is the correlation coefficient is 1. The range of correlation coefficient is always lies between minus 1 to plus 1. If the interpretation of r is, if the correlation coefficient r is equal to 1, then it is very highly correlated. But we get 1 plus here. So it is highly positive correlated. So the answer to the given question is, compute correlation coefficient, that we have computed the correlation coefficient for the given data, that is 1, and interpret its value. That means if the value of R is greater than 0.8, then it is highly correlated. If the value of R is less than 0.8 but greater than 0.3, then it is moderate correlated. And if it is less than 0.3, then it is very low correlated. The sign indicates it is negative correlated or positively correlated. If we get negative value in between the range 0 to minus 1, then we can say that the correlation is negative. And if we get the value from 0 to plus 1, then we can say that the correlation is positive. But the value 0.8 and above is highly correlated, that in case of negative correlation or in case of positive correlation. The interpretation of the given problem is it is highly positive correlated because we get the value of R as 1. So this is for correlation coefficient. In the next video, we'll see how to find out the missing terms in the given bivariate data. Thank you.